Snacks in Norway tier list. Rank it now. Okay. This is something I have to think about. Okay, let me see what I've never tried before. I haven't tried this one before. I'm not sure about this one. This is just random the things you can choose, so that can be whatever. Freya melkesjokolade, first prize. Turkish pepper. Okay, we can just start. This is really Swedish. They take in even a Swedish version of it in the pictures, but that's fine. I'll still rate it. That is C tier. It's decent, but it isn't anything good. It's like mid. Baseline, yeah? Mid. You can't eat this with mussels. Yes, you can eat a lot of it with mussels. Smash should have been there if it isn't. Chili nuts. This is the best. This is S tier. Have anyone tried chili nuts? I'll tell you, that is, when I was younger, I was eating that all the time. It's so fucking good. That is S tier. And I'm not going to place a lot of this on S tier, but that is S tier. It's peanuts with a layer of, I'm not even sure what the layer is made of, but with chili. It is really fucking good if you haven't tried it. Chili nuts, chili and lime, lemon, isn't it? I'm not sure what the lemon thing. Caramelized chili nuts. I don't think it's lemon, Everett. What brand is it? There's a lot of brands. This is the cheap one that isn't that good. Eldorado. It's a little bit spicy, but not too much. Another version has lime, okay. But this is the version that I like. Let's see. Coating. Salte chips. This is not normal chips. This is really good as well. I give this an A tier. I'm not sure how to describe how this one is. This is the first price brand. Maybe not the best brand of those, but those are really good as well. It's nice. To be honest, I don't know what this is. Oriental. Jakobs. Oriental. Oriental. Chili. Paprika. Ingefær. Yes, it is 100% there, Brett. Yes, this one is good. But oh my god, what a price! Well, my guess is that this is an A tier as well. Because I enjoy chips with the paprika taste. Is that pepper? Is that the name? Pepper? Red bell pepper taste chips is some of the best. Bilar in Norway? I don't know. Siesta Fiesta. Is that the name? I don't know. Because I haven't tasted exactly this one. So I will just keep this. Lay's sour cream and onion. Sour cream and onion chips is one of my favorites. I haven't tried Lay's version of this. But put Gomp on that list. I think those are a little bit better than this one, so I will pull this one down to B. Dill pickle lace? No. Moritz potetgull salt. This is the original. This is the chips, like the gold standard of chips. Probably the first one. It's always good. But how do we rank that one? I will say B. It doesn't taste that much. I miss candy. Don't eat much of it. Used to love me some Airheads. I don't know what that is. I don't eat much either, but at night, my weakness when it comes to this shit is at nighttime when I wake up. So often when I go to bed and I'm really full, around, when are we going to bed? Maybe 4 a.m. I wake up like 5, 6 a.m. because I fall asleep in 2 minutes and then I'm sleeping. And then I wake up 1 hour almost every day later, and I go, and I'm hungry, and I go and eat some shit. Pringles. This is worldwide. I would say this is mid-tier. That's my opinion. It is okay. It isn't the best, but it's like, it's basic. It isn't bad. Normal, not as good as other flavor. Maybe not. But then we come to the gold standard, how it should be. Sørlands chips. Any Norwegians that agree with me when I play Sørlands chips on top? Any Norwegians that would disagree? Has the best flakes ever, that is true. I saw Americans eating Biler Sunday, they love them. And the Vikings Sørlands chips is number one, yes. Super chips, do you know what? I like this one pretty well. I'm not sure if it's A or B. But Morud Superships is pretty good. It's so easy to eat. A whole bag takes you 2 minutes, and then the bag is empty. If you start on a bag like this, it will be empty. Mexican Fiesta, I haven't tried it, so I don't know. That's the problem with those bags. They're empty so fast, but I think there isn't. I would choose Sørlandet over that one. Remember when they had more fat, so much more tasty rip, super ship. Totenflak is also, that's basically the same as Sørlandet ships. Those two are basically the same. So they take, it isn't that big a difference. Those, is there any? I don't even remember the name of them. Lollipops. I don't know, fucking know. It isn't anything for me. It's okay taste, but that's it. Dent. Feel like that is the same. Fisherman's Friend. It isn't my kind of candy, if you can call it candy. It's like mid, low mid, a little bit below middle. Haribo, but what does it say here? Orange cake? Not even if free. I think I've tested them. They have this layer that tastes so bad in the middle. Isn't that it? And I haven't tasted those. I think I can't remember at least. M&M, those are pretty good. I would say, I'm not sure if A or B tier. It's chocolate with nuts. It is pretty good. Okay, we can put them on F. No, I wouldn't eat this if it was free. I don't like reg M&Ms, but I love me some peanut butter and peanuts M&Ms. I haven't tried that. Nonstop, that isn't my thing. I'm putting it in D tier. Nonstop isn't my. I wouldn't choose this. It isn't like really bad, but it's below. Orange cake divides countries. Some people absolutely hate them, others absolutely fancy them. This one, what is it? Nonstop, you know what that is. Cheese doodles. Oh, is that a S tier? Is cheese doodles also S tier? Because it's impossible to stop when you first start with those. There's no way you can't just eat the whole bag. Nothing beats cheese doodles on its uniqueness, true. Peanut, just the regular peanuts. I feel like that's an A tier. This is just regular peanuts, doesn't matter. It's just good. It isn't S tier like those, but it is good. It's like, that is really fucking nice. Cheese doodles are terrible in NA, I don't know. Popcorn. Popcorn is also really good. I would say that's A tier as well. Regular popcorn. Risbrød. I have to say, I don't remember how this tastes. Rox, Fox, Nox. Rox and Fox is pretty good. Nox is mid tier. I'll put them there. Soletti. Now some people will probably hate me, but I feel like that is mid tier as well. I feel like that is mid tier. It's good, but it isn't anything more than that. Laban, pretty good. Here we have two different milk chocolates. I haven't tasted this one, but I guess since this is some cheap version, probably there. Freia melkesjokolade. It's a good A tier. It's good, but it isn't on top. I don't know what Jakobs belgiske trøfler, how that tastes. Kinder. Isn't that pretty A tier? Why did they fucking choose Kit Kat over why? How could they? If this was a Norwegian candy list, why the fuck is Kit Kat on this list? Can someone give me a good answer? Yeah, Kit Kat is good, but we have a different one. We don't have Kit. We might sell Kit Kat in Norway. What is the Norwegian version again? It is Quick Lunch. Replace with Quick Lunch. Yeah, we can call Quick Lunch. That is S tier. And I don't know this specific types of chocolate. Snickers. That is also A. Toblerone. Oh, it's such a long time since I tried that one. B tier chocolate. This can be everything, so it's impossible to rate. They have everything, just in small versions. This one is A tier. Toffee, I don't remember. Twist. D tier because it is a mix of good and not that good and some that is doesn't taste good. Turkish pepper. I think this is my list.